Hey guys, this is Amit. In this tutorial, we'll learn how you can add a background image in HTML using CSS. This is a tutorial in Notepad++. Now, let's say I'm working on this HTML page called index.html. It's a very simple site, and I can quickly view it from going to View, View Current File, and in Chrome. And this is how it looks. By the way, if you would like to learn how I opened a browser right from Notepad++, you can look at this tutorial that is linked right here. All right, so I went to View, View Current File. Actually, I can open in any browser. So I'm going to open in Chrome. And let's say I have a background image that I would like to put as a background. Not just as image, but the background image in this particular page. Now let's go back to my folder. This is my index.html file, and just I have organized my images in the under images folder. And if I go inside that, I have a file called background.png, and that is what I would like to put it as a background here. So again, my file is right here, and that's under images folder, the image. All right, so let's go back to our code. And I have created a simple body CSS property. Now, in order to create a background image, there is already a CSS property called background-image. And then the way in which you set the image is you type URL, parenthesis, single quote, and now I have images slash background dot png and quote, closing parenthesis and semicolon. Now, if you remember, the images folder is in the same working directory, and so the way in which you can access it is you put dot, that means your current directory, and then in your current directory there is an images folder, and then the background.png is the one that you are interested. So all I did is just created a very simple background image property for the body tag, and let's see how it looks. So I'm going to go to View again, View Current File, and Chrome. And there you go, you have the background image just added. Now, because the background image is a little darker, let's go ahead and change the text so it'll pop out. So here I have H1 and P tag, and the color is set to black. I'm going to change it to white. And I'll go back to my HTML, and if I refresh it, now I can see the image more clearly. Now, we still have one problem actually. If you look at the image, it seems like it's been stretched. Now, because the resolution of the image is pretty big, somehow it is not able to, you know, show it nicely to make it simpler. Now, there are different properties under image, a background image property in CSS that we can take advantage. So the very first is we would like to cover our whole image in the window that we have open in Google Chrome, right? And so there is a property called cover. And so if I go back, I can add another property, and it's called background, and actually it's called size, background size. And it's the value is cover. By the way, you can search online for more details about this particular property, but it's basically background size, and we would like to cover it so that it doesn't feel like stretched out or something like this. So I did that. I added the cover property. Let's refresh it and look at that. Now the whole image is nicely showing up in my browser window. Now there is another issue. Let's say I have an image which is smaller than my Chrome window. For example, I have another image called 800 pixel image width, and so I'm going to add the image, but now my background image is much smaller. So I will save it. I'll go back and refresh it. I need to remove the cover, sorry. So I'll remove this. Save. And if I refresh it, now you can see what is happening here is because the image size is small, it starts to repeat itself. Or if you are familiar with Windows, you know, background images, it's tile. I mean, it's just repeated afterwards. And so there is a way in which you can avoid that so that you can make sure that no matter what kind of, screen resolution is, it will never do that because it doesn't look very professional. And so it's called background repeat. And we don't want to repeat, so it says no repeat. And that's the property name. And if I refresh, save, and I'm going to refresh it. And as you can see now, it is not stretched. The reason why it's not stretched, because we commented or we removed that cover property. But at least it's not, you know, just repeating. And so it looks fairly nice. So now that I have that set, I can do background size and set it to cover. And save it and refresh it. And now it looks nice and clean. Now, we still have to look at one more property, but in order to demonstrate that, I need to have more text. So here I have very few, only three or four lines of text, but let me just go ahead and repeat this multiple times. So I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to just repeat this, okay? So I created a number of lines, which will basically be a scrollable. So I'll refresh it. And I may need some more. Actually, I can go it a little bigger. All right. And maybe I need a little more. All right, so save, go back, refresh. Now, if you notice, it's kind of tricky or hard to notice, but as I'm scrolling it down, actually the image in the background is also scrolling, right? And it's okay, but it may not look as good. And so what we would like is we would like it to be fixed. So it seems like the image, the background image is still in the fixed position and only the text is scrolling. So there is a property called a background attachment. And it is called fixed, the property value. And when we do that, it will make sure that the background image is also not scroll up and down as we scroll the text up and down. So that's called background attachment. So I'm going to save this and go back to my browser. And now you can see the difference. Right now, see, it is scrollable. But if I refresh this, and now if I see, look at this, it's very clean and very nice effect, where the background image is still and only text is going up and down. And so we looked into background image, how you can use repeat or no repeat, cover, and how we can fix the image attachment. So I hope you like this video and you learned something new about adding a background image in HTML using CSS. If you are interested in more HTML tutorials, I'm going to link some more right here. And if you like this video, please click like button or subscribe to my channel to learn more about such HTML and Notepad++ tips and tricks. All right. Thank you very much. Bye.